everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Zach Attack Reviews, where I break down the good, the bad, the ugly of movies, TV shows, trailers, and fan films. Today I'm going to be reviewing The Guilty on Netflix, starring Jake Gyllenhaal. Anything he's in, I'm going to watch. Sometimes his movies are bad, but he never gives a bad performance. And directed by Antoine Fuqua, hopefully I'm saying his last name correctly. He's done The Training Day, he's done Equalizer, and he also did Southpaw, which also starred Jake Gyllenhaal. This movie's premise is a police detective named Joe who has been demoted to desk duty at a 911 call center, and he gets a call seemingly from a woman that has been abducted. So now he's racing against time and trying to help this lady in the best way possible that he can. This movie was inspired by this Danish movie called Dan Skylage, which has a very similar premise but hits different story beats because of the cultural differences. This one kind of hits more on things that are going on in the US right now when it comes to relations with the police and civilians, and how they feel, how some civilians feel about police, and how some of the stresses that police are going through because of it. It's not something that's in your face, but it's an underlying theme that's going on in this movie with a bunch of other underlying themes. The feel of this movie feels like things like the movie with Halle Berry called The Call, which is very similar because she was in a 911 call center. Panic Room, because it's shot in one location for the most part, and they find a way to make it very interesting and intense. And The Phone Booth, which is another situation that's shot in one place, one situation kind of, and finding different ways. And, you know, he was on the phone going back and forth with someone, and that's what, you know, a 911 caller would be doing. So those are the four movies I think that this movie feels like and is inspired by. I'm going to start off with the good. First things first, I got to say my boy Jake, he comes in with another great performance. If you've ever seen any Jake Gyllenhaal, that is anything he's been, he does not, you know, half-ass anything. Even when he's doing a superhero blockbuster movie where some people don't take it seriously, like I love him as Mysterio and Spider-Man, he does a great job of playing a very, very complicated character. If another actor was in this role, it would make this movie very, very, very average. But his acting, his performance takes it to another level. He's playing this character that you can tell there's something off about him. Like he's gonna almost snap at any time. But he's trying so hard to do good. But because of his anger and the way he acts, some people are not, you know, cooperating with him as best as they could because he's an asshole. He's an asshole that's trying to do good for this lady that he thinks is abducted, and he's trying to help her get out of this situation. And you can see we get a little bit of information like in the first 5 to 6 minutes, which I thought was great, that he shows his personality within the movie, and slowly you start seeing, and he starts unraveling, you start getting little tidbits of why he's the way he is and why he's so angry and why everybody's so standoffish with him. So I thought Jake Gyllenhaal carried this movie with his performance. He did a great job as Joe. I can't just promote him as the sole reason this movie is good. I gotta give Antoine Fuqua a lot of credit for directing this movie really well. There are parts of this movie in the beginning where I was like, okay, this is a standard directing job, given, you know, really good shots, everything. It's the cinematography is really nice. Everything looks really good in this call center, a little better than I think call centers probably look. But as the movie got more intense, his directing got better. When Joe felt isolated, he pulled out to make you, you know, feel away from Joe because you could feel how he was. But when Joe was being intense, or there was an intense moment or a call that, you know, was super serious and he was maybe doing something he shouldn't be doing, he pulled really in. So you could see the emotion, you could see his eyes of desperation to try to save this woman. I gotta say that the people who were on the phone calls did a great job with the ADR and voicing over, because obviously we didn't get to see the other side of the call, so these were all voiceovers playing fully believable characters. You could kind of fully realize who these people were without even seeing them. So I think those guys get some credit. I'm not sure. I think it said Ethan Hawke, who was one of the voices, but I'm not sure who he played, because there's multiple people he ends up on the phone with. And Riley Keogh, sorry if I'm saying your name wrong, is probably the woman who was abducted. Another thing I gotta give this movie credit for, I thought it was gonna be just a standard movie of a man abducting a woman, he's an abusive husband, but there's twists and turns, not only with that part of the story, but also with the characters themselves. Some of it you can kind of see coming from a mile away, but you're not too sure until it's revealed. So I think that was good. They were keeping you on the edge. And I gotta give it this movie props. This was the most intense feeling or movie I've had for an hour and 30 minutes straight in a long time. It was just, at first it was calm, but as soon as the call came in, it was kind of this ticking timing feeling you felt, where you were scared that this woman was going to be murdered or never be able to be found again. And the setting of it helped because it was it's in California, and there's a bunch of forest fires. So all the police and everything, they're scrambling right now. They're getting calls from everywhere trying to help so many different people. But Jake Gyllenhaal's character is so focused on helping this one person. And at first you're like, why is he so focused on this? Why is this one person to him so important when there's so many calls coming in? And as we get towards the ending and the middle and the ending of the movie, you start finding more about his personal life and why this is so important to him. So I thought the different layers of this movie, with Joe's personality and the things that was going on in his life, the back and forth with trying to figure out what was going on with this abduction, and then also the underlying storyline of police relations with civilians, was really interesting. And when it ended, it brought a really, really nice bow on top towards the end, where they tied all those things together. And you know, if you've seen any of my reviews before, I love when there's multiple storylines that tie in together. When things just get dropped off to the side, it really annoys me. It's like, why was that even in there? You just did it to just pique my interest and then just annoy me. But they really did a good job here in this movie. Let's talk about the bad. I don't really have too much bad to say other than that there was this moment towards the end of the movie where he had interaction with a cop that was within that call center that was trying to say something positive and uplifting, but instead of it being a natural conversation, she kind of just went off with this one word cliche line, and it didn't land for me. It didn't work. It felt unnatural, like they ran out of time and they were like, okay, let's just throw this out there. And it felt really weird, and I felt like that was the moment that was supposed to be like a realization turner for him, for his own personal life, because he goes off to do something else that's life-changing for him. So, and because he admits something. So I wish that was executed a little better, but it wasn't terrible, but it made that moment, particular moment, land flat. So let's talk about our verdict. So between Jake Gyllenhaal's great performance, Antoine Fuqua's really good directing, and the twists and turns and the intensity of the movie that kept me engaged for all of it, I think this movie was really good. But I think that because, like, I compared it to Phone Booth, Panic Room, and other movies that's similar to this, where it was situation, I don't think it rises above those movies. And because of that, I give this movie a C+. So guys, let me know if you saw the movie, what you think. Like my video, tell me how you feel about my review, comment down below, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and you can check out more reviews, reactions right now.